Welcome to the video. How cool is this? Everything is disintegrating here. The tripod's falling apart. I have no place to plug in the camera. The Nook is torn apart. I couldn't record inside. I'm outside here in the nighttime. This is something. But it's very great. It just shows you that nothing will stand in our way to get the truth out. It's a very sensitive time right now, so I'm having to talk very quietly here. There's an awareness right now that something is going to happen for sure. I have a pretty good idea what's going to happen. There's actually more than just one situation that's going to happen, but there is going to be a very big situation, very likely to occur. And so let's, instead of saying exactly what that is, I'm not going to say exactly what it is, but I am going to say what is important about the future coming up very soon, the false flags that will happen, plunging the world into turmoil, actually. What's important is this. One either turns toward reaction or repentance. Reaction or repentance, that is the choice that everyone is faced with. Reaction or repentance. I'm here to say that repentance is the way. Repentance is the way. Repentance is the way. Repentance leads to your realization that what happens in this realm doesn't matter. Doesn't affect higher realms at all. Doesn't affect higher realms. Doesn't affect truth at all. Lies don't affect truth. This realm, we don't need this realm. We do not need this realm at all. Okay, the Luciferian satanic rebellion needs this realm. This is their place. So they need it. We don't need it. Once you repent, you realize you don't need this realm. And so what we need to realize during these times that are coming is to turn towards repentance, where you don't react to what's happening in the world. Stay absolutely calm, because you know that the higher realm, the realm that transcends this realm, is not being affected by anything that takes place here. Is not being affected by anything that takes place here at all. So this is what's likely to happen, is the events that are going to take place are certainly going to stir up enormous turmoil and reaction. The world is going to be plunged into a massive reactivity. Concurrently with that, concurrent. Now is concurrent with time, okay. Concurrently with that, there will be those who will seem to be graced with the light of the higher realm, okay. Light in a less condensed light. They will seem to be enlightened. And they, the enlightenment that is with them, the light that is with them, will not be reacting to the events of the world. And so these beings in this world will have this incredible equanimity and absolute stillness and calm. And those who want to repent will say, hey, let us put our attention here. I have said that there's a massive world war taking place, and there most certainly is, and it's a war for our attention. Where do we place our attention? Do we place it on reaction, or do we place it on repentance? This is the question. This is the war. So in order to win, quote-unquote, you know, prevail in this war, we need to shift our attention onto repentance, and repentance leads to the realization that pure spaciousness has no preferences. So how could there be a conflict in pure spaciousness? How could there be a true conflict? There cannot be. There must be peace. There's only peace. The condition of truth and reality is only peace. And so those who put their attention, who are able to put their attention on a repentance, will have available in this world those who have this light about them, who will, the super calm, peaceful light, and they will be able then to put their attention upon that, and their repentance will go in such a manner that it will be supremely beneficial to them. They will not be pulled down into the darkness of reactivity here. The events that are to come are designed for maximum reactivity, maximum reactivity. And so it's very possible to get pulled down into that maelstrom, a tsunami of reactivity, an absolute global tsunami of reactivity. We don't want to get pulled down in that. Okay, so I've called upon the light. I said, okay, I'll do it. I agreed. Okay, I'll be one of those who do this. And so I expect that that will happen for me. I just recently said, okay, you know, it's been Holy Spirit's explained it to me sufficiently. I said, all right, I'll go ahead and do that. Why not? Beats the alternative, that's for sure. People will come and be quiet. They'll be still, they'll be quiet. There will be this profound meditation, profound repentance. Mood of repentance will be very profound. And they'll have this immense positivity about them. Remember, the light of the higher realm is not reacting to this light here, what takes place here. It's not reacting. So there's this, no matter what happens here, the light is absolutely blissful and peaceful and calm and positive. Doesn't matter what takes place here in this realm. This is the realm of trying to prove that a lie is true. And since a lie is not true, there's nothing to react to, actually. You will find that this light does not react to lies. For instance, let's say you were looking at a tree. And for instance, that we're out here and it's nighttime, but there's a tree there and there's all these breezes here. Air is moving in breezes, but does that affect my vision of the tree? Can I not see the tree clearly even though the air is, you know, all these air currents moving all over the place? It's like that. What happens in this world are like air currents, just, you know, of relativity. One air current relative to the other. But if you see it as non-relative, it's all clear. But it's just clear air moving around, so to speak. It doesn't affect vision of truth. It doesn't affect it. As soon as we try to get dualistic and see, well, which is better, you know, get preferential, then all the events seem to take on solidity and it becomes opaque. This world becomes opaque and you cannot see the higher light. But when you don't do that, and you realize that there are no preferences, therefore there's no conflict, nothing to discern here in the realm that is trying to induce us into judgment of what God's preferences are, we realize there is nothing to discern here. Therefore there's no relativity saying, well, this is preferred and in relation to this, what is the relation there? Then it takes on this kind of solidified, conflictual, perceptual, and becomes darker and darker and darker and darker, and you get led into darkness here. So we want to be a light in the darkness. We're going to be a light in the darkness, true light in the darkness, so people can say, yeah, I don't have, that light is available to all, everyone. I do not have to succumb to the darkness. I do not have to be pulled into the darkness. We will be surrounded by darkness in this world, and yet there will be lights, lighthouses in that darkness, where those who accept the path of repentance, which is just simply working on your continuity fear, okay, which is doable. Continuity fear, you can work on it, all right? Lie, if you accept the lie to be true, you can't work on it. When you accept that you do have a severe continuity fear, you simply begin, there are many, many ways to work on it, and you gradually evaporate it away. Okay. So, this is the gist of the situation. This is the gist of it. These different lights will be in different places in the world, and people will be able to, in one way or the other, be aware of this. There may be many. I don't know how many there will be. There could be many, many, many throughout the world. The light will come and seem to abide with them. And because they agreed to do it, they said, okay, all right, I'll do that. Understanding level confusion for what it is. It's not a preference, you see. See, reality is not a preference, it's a fact. So those who choose to serve reality are not serving preference, they're serving fact. Yeah. So, you know, I say, oh, it's just reasonable to serve fact. So it's not saying, well, God preferred those who the light comes to those that means God prefers them. No, it means that they have accepted it's reasonable to serve fact, right? To serve all, to serve the truth is reasonable. That's all. It just means that their reason has been cultivated and activated and cultivated, and they spent a lot of time working on their reason. That's all it means. It doesn't mean that God prefers them at all. No. Of course, the Luciferians will insist that it does, because level confusion is what they trade in, you know. It's insanity. But again, that doesn't matter. We will not react to what happens. Now, what's going to happen is probably going to happen very soon. And, so all of this is going to get going very soon. I know we say very soon. People hear very soon, very soon, very soon. Well, it's coming down to the nitty-gritty for sure. That's why I've been put on such an enormous push here to say yes. Say yes, okay, I'll do it. No problem. And so this is what I believe is going to happen. This is the situation where the sheep and the goats will be separated. Those who react and those who repent, all right, are going to be separated out. And the separation is going to be huge, because those who react are going to be pulled down into just this incredible darkness of conflict. And may God have mercy upon them, because that is no fun for sure. And those who choose the path of repentance are going to be lifted up into the higher realms at some point for sure. And the difference is night and day. You know, it's just a massive, massive difference. Can't split the difference. The difference is so huge, you can't sit on that fence. You cannot sit on that fence. It's like the difference between one and zero. Where's the fence between one and zero? Please tell me, anyone? No. Can you sit on that fence? Is it possible? It's not possible. So for me, I'm just saying, wow, the light comes and it's going to be absolutely still and absolutely peaceful, and I just have to accept it. It's like, okay. It's like that. I just say, wow. And just say, okay, you know, abide here. It's okay. I don't know how I'll feel about it, but I just have to get used to it, really. You know, that's just how I look at it. Just have to get used to it. It's entirely reasonable. You see, it's entirely reasonable, and then so it's a matter of getting used to it. Now, maybe it may be a process of continuity fear with me, I'm sure, to get used to it. People will probably, you know, notice. They'll start noticing. Say, hey, you know, what's that? What's up with this? And just, you know, I'd say, oh, I'm just for a couple, you know, maybe for a couple years, I'm just going to do this and just hang out like this. Okay. And just use the discipline I have to allow that to happen. It's not a real fun time, actually. Making decision, fundamental decisions is not easy, and people are irritated about it for sure. I understand that. It's like, wow, why do I have to be pressured like this? That's not fair. That's not, yeah. But it's happening. It's happening. And so you just make the decision, and you know, you say, okay, it's just going to be, once I make the decision, okay, it's just work. Get to work. Get to work. That's all. This is my path. This is my path. I've had it with this, you know, crazy, stupid, Luciferian revolution, rebellion, you know, God has preferences thing. It's just nonsense. I'm tired of it. I've had it. I've had enough. I've had enough. That's all. Now I've got a severe continuity problem. It's my responsibility to deal with that, and I'm dealing with it through repentance. And this is the help. God's giving some help here. Holy Spirit's giving some help. So I'm going to use the help and just get to work, and you know, that's fine. That's my path now. And you just kind of look at it that way. It's a very much a pragmatic, very pragmatic and reasonable. That's all. That's it. And you just keep that pragmatism and reasonableness within you. And then you just accept it and say, okay, I'm just going to get with the program here and make the most of it. Period. That's all. Needless to say, you don't want to spend your time watching television coming up. That is for sure. So, we'll see what happens. Right now my studio is not available, and it's pretty interesting, but I may do Google Hangouts. I don't know. Is there a way to do video there? I may do live. Well, I don't know what's going to happen, actually. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. This is pretty important information. Now, as far as what is going to happen in the world, again, I'm not going to say, because I don't want to attract, you know, the crowd here that is only curious about sensationalism. You know, if I said what was going to happen, it's so sensational, everybody will stampede here and say, oh my gosh. No, I'm only interested in those who are interested in repentance. That's it. So I'm only calling those who are interested in repentance, saying, hey, you know, our time has come. Help is going to be here. And there'll be different affiliations and all sorts of different affiliations. That's all, it doesn't matter. It's the quality of the light that's all important. The non-reactivity of the light is what is important. Everything else is meaningless. Forget about factionalism, sectarianism, preferentialism, all this nonsense. It's the quality of the light. Is the light peaceful? Is it calm? Is it absolutely, does it have this wonderful feel to it, truly? Is it the true light, you see? That's all that matters. External form, words, concepts, don't matter. Because truth is one. Truth is very simple. The ground of being, God, the God of creation, is not engaged in the game of preferences. Game of preferences, no way. Just look at the space in front of you. Is that space in front of you? Is that judging what's there? Is it having preferences what's there? Is it loving? Is it hating? Well, the God of creation is loving all. It's all loving. As Jesus said, God is love, period. It's loving all, always. Meaning there are no preferences for anything to appear, manifest, or not manifest. To come out of an unmanifest state or to go back in the unmanifest state. Either way, it's all, God is all loving. This is the truth. So this is just a simple truth that we're all simply headed for. That is all. And we simply have a continuity problem. How we, each one of us, resolves a continuity problem can differ widely, very widely, because of all our unique adjustments we've been trying to make to the premise of preferences. So there's a great, great diversity in the way that we evaporate our continuity fears. It's all good. It does, you know, I've never been bothered by anyone different ways of doing it. Just say, it's fine. You want to do it that way? That's fine. Just, you know, just get it done. That's all. Get it done. Because, again, truth doesn't require proof to be true. It does not require proof to be true. Truth is true, regardless of whether anyone believes it or not. Okay. So, it's simply evaporating the continuity fear. There's really infinite ways to do it, actually. Simply get it done. That's all that's important. And by all means, get it done in a quick way if you can, or in a way that's most suitable to you. And certainly go for it, you know, as much as you possibly can. That's what's important, is discipline, is everyday discipline, putting everything you've got into it, and managing the path, you know, managing, because your foot will be on the brake and then on the accelerator, vice versa, you know, and you'd have to learn how to manage it. That's true for no matter what way you take. There will be this management issue of how can I keep it smooth and make the progress. So we talk about these big issues here like that, the overarching context of the whole path here, just get like an overview of how it goes. So I'm trying to keep my calm here, knowing that the D-Day is coming. You know, there's always a D-Day, isn't there? Absolutely there is. And unfortunately, we're headed for one right now. So I hope this has given you a flavor of what is to come, that you know, don't be worried, or the light understands. The light understands there's many ways to evaporate the continuity fear. Holy Spirit understands. The Holy Spirit's a pragmatist. The grace of God is very pragmatic. So don't get caught up in sectarian stuff, preferential stuff. Don't worry about anything. Just say, yeah, you know what? That's what I'm going to do. Okay. I'm tired of reacting to this realm. Really tired of reacting to this realm. I want to know that there's all this reactivity in this realm, belongs to this realm. It has nothing to do with reality, the death-free realm, the higher realms, the non-reactive realms. It has nothing to do with it. It doesn't affect it in any way. It doesn't affect it in any way. It doesn't bother it in any way. Much ado about nothing here. Absolutely much ado about nothing here. And we can experience that and get the flavor of it on the path of repentance. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. So it's a great opportunity for us right now. And all right, I will put this up to YouTube and just keep on trucking here. Absolutely. Very great. That's it.